Welcome back to the Auto Obsessive Garage. Chadwick with you again for another installment of the Auto Experience Series. And that's our in-depth review series featuring pretty dang cool cars. At least cool in my opinion. Where we go subjective, objective, talk about just about everything about the car. So stay tuned for the following action. Yeah, it's going to be a good one today, guys. I'm actually piloting a 2006 Lexus LS430. The LS is Lexus's flagship. This has been their super sedan, if you will, because this is what launched Lexus. The LS400, the first gen, really, they had to put their foot in there, and they put a strong foot down, guys. It competed with luxury cars, and they paid way too much to develop that car, but guess what? It solidified what Lexus is today. You've heard of Lexus? It's because of this car's grandfather. So this is effectively the third generation of the LS. The second gen was really just still the LS400, but a little bit of a tweak to it. This is the 430, and this is when Lexus naming conventions made sense. There's a 4.3 liter V8, the 3UZ FE. One of the best motors ever made by Lexus and Toyota, and I say that all the time about these V8s, these UZs, but truth be told, they really are. In terms of power output, very solid, very understressed, and hyper reliable. Just ridiculous lifespans out of these things. Not uncommon to see a 200 to 300,000 mile LS430 cruising around. This one, on the other hand, belongs to my good buddy Frank. Shout out to Frank and him being my, you know, host on our podcast. We do a little automotive podcast talking about weird cars. It's called Another Pointless Automotive Podcast. It makes sense. So shameless plug there. Check it out. But this is Frank's LS, and it is sporting 66,000 miles, guys. This is an incredibly low mileage, super clean example, and I'm super happy. Super happy to be driving it today, and big thanks to Frank. It's kind of the last reign of these super reliable Lexus big cruisers. Obviously, the LS460, good power, not as reliable, but Lexus overall, still pretty damn reliable. But this was it, man. I think the LS430 is kind of where the road stopped for this car. Oh, it's a peach. Some would say maybe even the most perfect car ever created, and more on that soon. There's a lot of factors that bake into a statement like that, right? Like, what do you want out of a car? And this is what we ask ourselves. I drive a lot of cars, I own a lot of weird cars, and there's certain things I like, certain things I don't like, and the average person probably has some differing opinions. But for this car, what it does right, very few people find issues with. You know, we got a good, reliable V8 power plant. Off to a great start. Rear-wheel drive, awesome. Opulent, cushy, well-made interior. Love that. Fuel economy, meh. Not its strong suit, but it's I don't know. It's presentable. I don't know how to say that. It just it does pretty good for the power it has and the heft it's bringing around the corners here as we cut up the canyons. But it's just a fantastic car. The values of these, if we're already going to jump, let's jump right into market talk. You know we're going to do it. All over the place, guys. A 300,000 mile paint shot, interior ripped up example, going to be had for, I don't know, $5,000, $7,000, maybe even less if you negotiate. But you're talking low mileage like this, you're going to pay a premium. I think this is a right around 15K car. Not going to lie, 66,000 miles, one owner before. My buddy Frank got his hands on it. And the condition it's in, yeah, this is at the top of the market. But we're talking about $15,000 for a car that offers everything this car offers. And to me, just the luxury aspect of it, the way it rides, the unbelievable way it rides. And I don't know, how about that rock solid, reliable power plant? There's a lot that bakes into that. I mean, there's a lot going for this car, and that is a small price point. And does that add to its perfection? Absolutely. To be able to get all this in an affordable package, sign me up. But yeah, these are just great cars. I mean, What are you going to say? I mean, maybe the styling isn't your cup of tea. It's a pretty sedate design. That's fine. Yeah, it's just, it's a lot of bang for the buck. It's, again, one of the most reliable cars. And we're going to shake it down today, guys. We're going to see how much this thing weighs, because I think it's pretty hefty. Find the front and rear balance. See if it's a balanced car. Going to check out that acceleration time. 0-60, quarter mile. See if this V8 really does V8 things. And then we're going to just drive it around. And see how it handles up here in the twisties. As you can see, beautiful corners, beautiful day, beautiful scenery, as always. And we'll talk about the interior, exterior, all the kind of fun stuff that makes this car what it is. So today, let's set out on our quest to find out if the Lexus LS430 is the most perfect car ever made. Good corners here. On to the objective tests. With the Lexus LS430 up on the scales, let's get that curb weight and front and rear balance. At just over 4,100 pounds, the Lexus LS430 is not a svelte sports car, clearly. It's carrying around a lot of heft. It's got a big motor. It's got a lot of luxury. These things just add up. When a modern GTR is a fair bit lighter than you, you are a heavy car. Look at the other heavy hitters, if you will, surrounding our LS430. There's some big boys on there, and the LS is happy to be amongst their ranks. Okay, enough fat shaming the LS. Check out this weight distribution front and rear. 53 over the front, 47 over the rear. This is really good weight balancing for a front engine rear wheel drive car, and the LS does it well. Examining that 0-60 time to other cars I've tested on the channel, not a slow car is in sight. Also, bonus points for matching his cousin, the SC430's, speed. Actually beating it out a little bit. Go LS! The LS line of cars from Lexus was never intended to be associated with the word sports. In the third installment of this moniker, that still remains the case. The LS430 does not fall short in the power department, boasting nearly 300 horsepower. It truly never leaves you daydreaming about more power. It's able to effortlessly pull away from stoplights and maintain highway speeds without breathing deeply or spinning the engine fast at all. It's a comfy cruiser. A veritable consumer of road trip mileage. Handling is quite impressive given the LS430's heft. It's not the wallowing affair that you would assume it to be. I'd label it as competent. Read that as not really ideal for anything above 7/10 on a canyon road. Let's just summarize the driving experience as it being an insulated, comfortable, yet powerful cruiser. Excitement was certainly not dialed up on the LS430 exterior design. It hails from a softer, more bubbly Lexus design era, and it wears this design ethos proudly. The previous generations were more blocky, substantial in design. With the follow-up act, the LS460 introduced more of the modern Lexus angular design language. This LS430 design isn't offensive. It's just a little too soft for my taste, as it's a challenge to find a single straight surface or any edge. That being said, for Lexus, this design works. This was, of course, the age of older or more experienced Lexus owners, and a non-offending design goes a long way to satiate this group. If you prefer your interiors with large volumes of wood and leather, the LS430 is where you want to cozy up for a long road trip. Lexus could do no wrong during this era on the interior front.
Materials are of an exceptionally high grade and stand up quite well against the ravages of time. Some pretty nifty tech is also sprinkled in here, such as oscillating air vents and a cassette player. This was par for the course, as the LS platform was always the Lexus tech demo flagship car. Highly functional, yet opulent, the interior of the LS430 will never cease to be comfortable. This is my favorite period of Lexus interior design, as it presents a statelier manner than the more modern, tech-focused layouts of the brand's current offerings. Can Lexus slash Toyota do any wrong with their UZ-FE V8 power plants of this era? The answer is an obvious no. The 3UZ-FE is a 4.3-liter quad overhead cam V8 that pumps out 290 horsepower, up 40 horsepower from the original LS400, and a torque rating of 320 pound-feet. That is quite a bit of power and torque. Power delivery is silky smooth on partial throttle and surprisingly abrupt on firm pedal stabs, allowing it to be useful in a multitude of driving scenarios. Even better than the power specs is this engine's absolutely stunning reliability. Falling right in line with its predecessors, the 4.3-liter V8 in the LS430 has a well-documented penchant for longevity and is often considered the best Toyota slash Lexus engine of all time. Regular timing belt and water pump changes will keep this engine motoring on for literal eons. Lexus keeps the transmission choice an easy one here by only offering a 6-speed automatic. In the earlier LS430s, you get a 5-speed automatic. Here's where most folks would make a cursory judgment call, as labeling this as ancient technology given the gear count. More gears equals better, right? Well, not always. I actually prefer the 6-speed auto gearbox to the later 8-speed and higher offerings. I find there to be far less gear hunting, and full throttle downshifts just seem to be more fluid and immediate. This is one of my favorite auto gearboxes, which actually saw action in many Lexus Toyota applications. It's reliable, and it functions as it should. This gearbox certainly wins the Best Supporting Actor award to the celebrated power plant it's bolted up to. How would you go about defining the concept of a perfect car? Without doubt, it would need to have ample power and reliability. This combo qualifier right here is a challenge to many vehicles, but we're not stopping just yet. We also would require a comfortable interior comprised of higher quality and soft touch materials, as we actually would want to spend time in our perfect automobile. A non-offensive exterior is also on the list. A design that is not overly complicated nor dated is a must. Price point is a factor too, as too lofty a price would certainly disqualify it from a perfect acceptable cost label. I honestly think that I would elect the LS430, this very car, as being that near perfect car, a near perfectly executed automobile overall. It has an impressively reliable V8, which is more than capable in the power delivery department. The interior is comfortable, spacious, and well-appointed, with a forest and a half of some excellent lumber and two herds of cattle leather. The fact that you can get all of this for a remarkably approachable price point solidifies this proclamation of near perfection. There is no truly perfect car, but the Lexus LS430 gets you pretty damn close.